Jyoti Sharma and you're watching Agribusiness News. Let's start with the latest agribusiness updates. UPL Limited, a global provider of sustainable agriculture products and solutions, has received the prestigious Asian Sustainability Leadership Award for Excellence in Sustainability Performance Management for displaying commendable commitment to sustainability. Dr. Mrityunjay Chaubey, Global Vice President, Environment and Sustainability, UPL Limited, commenting on the achievement, said, "We at UPL are constantly working to improve sustainability in agriculture, as this has been a part of our core philosophy since inception and is practiced in our business across the value chain." Coromandel International Limited launched their 6 new products through Krishi Jagran and Gromor Suraksha Facebook page live. The EVP and Business Head of Coromandel, N.K. Rajavelu, has said,
"As we launch 6 new products, I must also say that Coromandel has invested heavily on product development and R&D, and I can assure you that the pipeline for Coromandel in terms of new products is going to be there. And as Mr. Ramesh said, we are going to launch at least 4 to 5 new products every year."
FMC India celebrated World Environment Day with a nationwide campaign to highlight the value of stewardship among the farmers, as well as the planting of trees across the country. With the upcoming Kharif season in mind, FMC organized 730 farmers meeting across 16 states, reaching more than 28,000 in the farming community. Mr. Pramod Toda, President of FMC India, said, "Our emphasis this year for World Environment Day was on educating farmers on best practices to enhance sustainable agriculture." ASSOCHAM announced webinar on cold chain technologies, convergence and capacity building on 17th June 2021 with the aim to promote investment in cold chain sector, showcasing and promoting latest technology opportunities, discuss safety and standard issues and to promote business potential in this sector. Kirloskar Brothers Limited, the leading pump manufacturer in India, has opened an advanced technology product division at Kirloskar Wadi Factory. ATPD has primarily been built as a dedicated manufacturing division for high-end technology products, especially those used for nuclear applications. Cropin Technology is going to organize the latest edition of the AG FinTech webinar series on digitalizing crop insurance on 23rd June 2021 at 3 p.m. India's largest agri e-commerce platform, BigHeart, launched its website in Hindi and it's providing wide choice of quality inputs to farmers at their doorstep. BigHeart co-founder and CEO Satish Nukala said,
"I'm quite excited today with the launch of Hindi language on our website. This gives us a huge leverage and a reach to millions of farmers from Hindi regions across the country. This will allow the farmers to access the platform with the ease and benefit from accessing huge knowledge repository as well as product know-how. BigHeart launched this initiative to accelerate the digital adoption towards our mission of transforming the future of farmers."
Hyderabad-based research organization Indian Institute of Rice Research, ICRIIRR, has released 4 new rice varieties, namely DRR Dhan 53, DRR Dhan 54, DRR Dhan 55 and DRR Dhan 56 recently. Punjab Agriculture University Ludhiana organized a Zoom call guest lecture on linking farmers producer organization to market. The guests were Dr. Jashkaran Singh Mehal, DDE, Dr. T.S. Ryer, Additional Director Communication, Dr. V.K. J.R. Raghavendra Rao, Principal Scientist ICRIIHR, and Dr. Kuldeep Singh, Head Department Extension Education. Bangalore woman Jinsi Samuel is growing 230 types of fruits, veggies and even prawns on her soil-free terrace by using novel methods like hydroponics and aquaponics that are shift away from the typical soil-based methods. For more agri updates, keep watching Krishi Jagran. Thank you.